Alright, we're on multiplying polynomials, part 5. I want you to put the video on pause and use any method, foil, box, smiley face, vertical format, to multiply the following. So, I've used these methods in previous videos on multiplying polynomials. And when you're done, then get off pause. Okay, let's go to the first one. 2x plus 3 times 2x plus 3, and let's go ahead and use the vertical format. 2x times 2x is 4x squared. 2x times 3 is plus 6x. Then negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x, and negative 3 times 3 is negative 9. So what do we get here? We get 4x squared minus 9. Alright, let's do m minus 4 times m plus 4. Let's use the FOIL method. So remember, we're doing first, outer, inner, last for the FOIL method. So we've got m times m for the first in each parentheses, that's m squared. Then the outer term is the m times the plus 4, which will be a plus 4m. Then the inner term will be a negative 4m. And the last term will be negative 4 times 4, last in each parentheses. And what happens here? Well, the middle terms, again, they end up canceling out. I just get m squared minus 16. So let's put that in. M squared minus 16. Let's do the third one using the smiley face method. Okay, remember, make a smiley face. Alright, so we have this arc, a times a is a squared, and then this arc, b times negative b is negative b squared. And we have the little chin here, b times a. Now, I'm going to write that in alphabetical order. It's easier to do that when you have to deal with like terms. And that's a plus ab, right? And then the outer term is a times negative b, it's minus ab. So notice, these are going to cancel out as well, the ab and the minus ab. So I bring down the a squared, that's going to be plus 0, minus b squared. So now we can now write that one, a squared minus b squared. All right, notice anything interesting about all these? When I multiplied each of them out, I ended up with a binomial for each of them. Usually we get a trinomial, right? You get three terms. But in this case, I have 4x squared minus 9, just two terms. And in fact, in all of these, I have a subtraction sign. So these are differences, correct? 4x squared minus 9, m squared minus 16, a squared minus b squared. Now, why do you think that happened? Well, look inside these parentheses. Notice in each case, what's in the parentheses, the terms in each parentheses are exactly the same, except one has a plus and one has a minus in each of them. So I have 2x plus 3 and I've got a 2x minus 3. Here I have an m minus 4 times an m plus 4. An a plus b times an a minus b. So what happens is when I multiply the first terms in each, I'm really multiplying the same thing times itself. I ended up getting a perfect square, 4x squared is the perfect square of 2x times 2x. M squared is a perfect square because it was m times m, and a squared was a perfect square, a times a. For the last term, why is it a minus? Because I had a plus and a minus, and a plus times a negative ends up being a minus sign. So I ended up getting, these are all called differences of two squares. I got a difference of two squares. And usually we write the formula as this last one that I put right here, a plus b times a minus b equals a squared minus b squared. So this is the formula for the difference of two squares. A plus b times a minus b equals a squared minus b squared. Now notice we got the answer to all of these without knowing that this was a formula. So if you don't notice anything and you just do the foil method, box method, smiley face method, whatever, you'll end up with a correct answer. Hopefully, if you don't make any mistakes. So here's a problem. Multiply 3x plus 4 times 3x minus 4. Let's go ahead and use the box method. We didn't do that yet. So we could write 3x plus 4, 3x minus 4, and let's fill in the box. 3x times 3x is 9x squared. 4 times 3x is plus 12x. 4 times negative 4 is negative 16. And 3x times negative 4 is negative 12x. And then remember we add along the diagonals, 9x squared. And what happens here? Again, 12x minus 12x is 0 and negative 16. So this answer is 9x squared minus 16. Again, we got a difference of two squares. Now, why don't we have that middle term? Well, if you look at the outer term and the inner term, they're going to be the same, except one's going to be positive and one's going to be negative. So here's the plus 12x and the minus 12x. Because you're multiplying these together, right? And those are the same things you're going to be multiplying together when you do the outer term. So the inner terms and the outer terms look exactly the same, except one's a plus and one's a minus. So what's the shortcut way of doing 3x plus 4 times 3x minus 4? Since you know the middle terms are going to cancel away, you're just going to take the first times the first, getting 9x squared, minus the last times the last. All right, so you could think of it this way. F plus L times F minus L equals F squared minus L squared. So you don't have to think of it as A plus B times A minus B. Whatever is the first in each parentheses, if it's exactly the same, you'll get F squared for first squared minus L times L, the last squared. And if the minus sign was in the first parentheses and the plus sign was in the second, you'll get exactly the same thing. So let's say we have, let's do something more interesting, M squared minus 3 times M squared plus 3. All right, let's do it the shortcut way using the formula. I'm going to have M squared times M squared. Now, I'm going to write this out this time just so it's real clear. If I write, that's first times first, or first squared, and this is last times last, or last squared. So somebody else may have thought of it as M squared squared minus 3 squared. We're going to get the same answer, though. Let's see. If I have M squared times M squared, remember when you have the same base, you add the exponents. So you have M to the fourth minus 3 times 3 is 9. You get the same thing here. Using the laws of exponents, m squared to the second power, you multiply exponents, you would also get m to the fourth, minus 3 times 3. Okay, so why don't you try this one? So put it on pause and see what you get, and then come back. Okay, it's just the first thing squared. How about we write it like that? It's the first thing squared minus the second thing squared. All right, so what's b cubed to the second power? Remember, you multiply exponents. Don't write b to the ninth. It's b to the sixth power minus 25. So instead of doing all four terms, you could just do the first squared minus the second squared. Now, do you need to always write that out even? I don't think so. What if you had x plus 7 times x minus 7? Could you do that without writing out 7 times 7? You could probably do that in your head. X times x is x squared minus 7 times 7 is 49. Okay. So that's using the formula for the difference of two squares. And it's going to be important to know that formula when we start factoring. You might not remember the formula, and you, at least if you do the FOIL method, you should still get the right answer of x squared minus 49. You might just have to do an extra step or two, but it's just a shortcut if you know the formula is going to be the difference of two squares. All right, so this is a special product. And go on to the next video, multiplying polynomials, part 6, for another special product.